Shalom, everyone. This is Chris Shoemaker, also known as Yehuda ben Shomer, and welcome to the Daily Drosh. Today's Daily Drosh is taken from Revelation chapter 3, and it says, I know all about you, how you are reputed to be alive and yet are dead. I want to talk about the new normal. You know, sometimes we have new things come across our path or into our life that excite us for a brief period of time, that energize us, that inspire us, that causes us to take action. And then that thing that was the catalyst for change becomes the new normal, and we become desensitized, and, you know, we become apathetic. And this isn't the way it should be. Again, it says, I know all about you, how you are reputed to be alive and are dead. Wake up, revive what little you have left and is dying fast. So far, I have failed to notice anything in the way of you, in the way you live, that my God could possibly call perfect. And yet, do you remember how eager you were when you first heard the message? Hold on to that. Repent. If you do not wake up, I shall come to you like a thief without telling you at what hour to expect me. You know, we got to get back to the beginning. We got to get back to the basics. We got to get back to that point in time when everything was fresh, everything was new, and we were excited and we took action. Kind of like getting a new job. When you get a new job, you're excited about the new job, excited about the new position. You give your 110%, and then after you're there and you get involved with the office politics and you get used to the routine and things become the same old, same old, you kind of slack off and you notice how everybody else is just skating by. Or maybe because you're new, everybody puts the work on you and they get to like skate by and kind of get back, lay back. And you're like, hey, you know, I'm not going to be the patsy anymore. You know, if they're going to get by with being lazy, I'm going to get by with doing the least I can do too. And we just, you know, we just kind of just fade into, you know, we become a wallflower. We just kind of fade into the background. Or remember when, you know, an event happens in the world or something happens on the news that tugs at your heart, that excites you, that causes you to go into action. You know, you think of you know, the 60s and the Vietnam War and all the protests and things like that. And then after a while, you know, it just kind of peters out and people aren't so concerned or about it anymore. Maybe it's because they don't see change, or maybe it's because they're sick of fighting and they're tired of the fight. I don't know. But it just seems so much worse today that things excite us just for a second and then it's over. Just like a shooting star and its brilliance just for a few seconds and then it's gone. It's like, you know, maybe it's because we have such a short attention span, or maybe because we expect to be catered to. You know, I mean, we have everything that's done in an instant, popcorn in 3 minutes, instant streaming of whatever music or shows that's on our brain or on our mind or that we want to hear or see. Boom, we can have it in an instant. Information through the internet at our fingertips. You know, we can get our eyeglasses done in about an hour, pizza in 30 minutes, you know, or less. And it's just crazy. And we just take things for granted. But, you know, one thing, we can't become apathetic or placid or routine in regards to our salvation, in regards to our life in Messiah, in regards to our life of faith. We need to continually be excited about it. Because you know what? We talk the talk, but do we walk the walk? I mean, we talk about how great God is and how great his word is and how much we love him and how much he does for us and how much he blesses us. And you know, we talk about doing great things in the world and we're excited about the gospel and excited about the word, excited about the truth. We want to share it with everybody and turn the world upside down and do great things for God. But yet we're still sitting in our armchairs watching Netflix. I mean, where is our action? Where is the action behind our words? We can't be all talk. We got to walk the walk. It says, I know all about you, how you are reputed to be alive and yet are dead. You know, you're reputed to be alive. You talk a good talk, but where's your life? You are reputed to be alive, and yet you are dead. Wake up, revive. That's the key there. Revival. Revive what little you have left and is dying fast. We need to wake up, and we need to get excited. We need to wake up, splash the cold water of the Word of God on our face, and get excited and get revived and go out there and take action and stop talking the talk. Talk leads nowhere. You know, we've got to take action. We've got to be excited about God and His Word. Hey guys, thanks so much for listening. Go out there and have a great day. Shalom and Shavua Tov.
Hey everybody, thanks for watching. And don't forget to check out and subscribe to our social media accounts on Instagram at AD_International, on Facebook at Abraham's Descendants International, on Twitter at ADINT Ministries, and on Blogger at Ray Bash's Ramblings. And don't forget to check out and bookmark our website, AbrahamsDescendants.com. Shalom.